Hello, it's me again. I'm Nafid. In this video, we'd like to talk or touch on the Git solution based either on the cloud base, which basically create a splash page that is cloud based, and we'll compare that solution with the ClearPass based Git. That's where the Git splash page based on the ClearPass itself. Let's go. So that's the access point we are talking about. Let's double check if it has connectivity to central. I'll show AP debug cloud server. So it is connected. No config being received, that's fine. But it is connected and managed by central. Now we go to central and double check our AP. So that's a central account and that's the access point. That's with the MAC address, which is the access point, if you like, name by default. Notice the MAC address ends up with A224, and that's the MAC address of that AP. We can double check going back. That's the name of the AP, and the MAC address is the same as the name by default. So we can look at this to A224. That's the name A224. So we know this is the AP. We can issue the command show activate. Also we can look at details like serial number here, activation key and so on. So that's serial number for this FFH7, and if we go back to central we can see this is the serial number as well. So we know we're targeting the correct access point. Now access point doesn't belong to any group in this case. We're going to create a group. We'll just create the group that is version 10. We map the access point to the group and we will start configuring the guest details. So we're going to have two examples of the guest using the cloud-based capture portal. And we're going to have guests using the ClearPass-based capture portal. So now we will go tools. And we will go console. Guest cloud and show AP BSS table. We should see being advertised on the 5 and the 2.4. So we're going to verify connectivity. This is a cloud-based guest using the cloud service basically, and let's see the behavior of the client. Now that's the client and we're going to connect to that cloud guest. This one and connect. So we can register. So we're going to provide a username password or you can sign in. So here, register. You can provide a mobile number. It's a UK mobile number in our case because, yeah, we can change it, of course. Yeah. That's my mobile, so I should be able to receive a message and they should be able to register me straight away. And on my mobile I should receive a message. And if we console to the access point and issue the command show clients, we should see the client connected. And the client, that's the operating system, that's the access point MAC address, channel 11 GN, which is basically .11n and 2.4. And that's the IP address of the client. And that was exactly expected. The client name is the mobile number. Okay. So now we're going to create another SSID. We will then, that new SSID will be guest and will use ClearPass as the authentication server as well as the capture portal holder. So that's ClearPass guest and we can see that the self-registration portal has been created or page. And if you look at that, how it looks like, we should expect the client to connect and receive something around this. So let's go back to central and just configure that in central. And we need to take a note of the name of the page. So that's our central. We add a new one and we're going to call it guest cppm. Next. Again, I would like to go for same interface, VLAN, same VLAN. The type is cloud guest or external. And here we have not defined anything for ClearPass profile. We're going to add it. We call ClearPass. Now we're going to say OK. So we will select that. And then that's the profile. Now this is where the location of the captive portal, and who's going to authenticate us is going to be, of course, ClearPass. We have not had any cloud authentication like Azure or AWS, but we'll go for the ClearPass itself. Leave everything as is. And we're going to go next. And then we're going to finish. Click OK. This is the solution. So now we look into the client. We can see CPPM, guest CPPM. That should redirect us if everything worked correctly. And that's because the fact we don't trust it, that's fine. We go advance. In theory, that should have been the fully qualified domain name and then public IP and all that stuff. So in this case, I can confirm. So they gave me the details here, and then I will log in. So I'm now connected correctly. Now I would like to show you one setting to make sure that you are aware of. When you do this for ClearPass, in ClearPass guest, so this is a ClearPass, and inside ClearPass guest, we need to make sure that the configuration of the page is correctly done. And specifically, I'm talking about the NAS filter ID or NAS ID. Look into this page that I have created in ClearPass, the self-register. The IP address for the NAS, this is, I've changed it from securelogin.arrivanetworks.com into securelogin.hpe.com. That's a default certificate, common name used by Aruba Central. You can use a different certificate. Of course, ideally, that should be your own certificate. But that solution will work with no problem whatsoever. So this is a certificate that is publicly signed and it will work. The initial error message we got in the client is because the ClearPass itself is not signed by public certificate. But after that, this has worked with no problem. So the trick here is if you don't want to buy a certificate specifically for that AP, then hpe.com or securelogin.hpe.com will work in your case. So if we go console to the AP or remote console, SSH to the AP, and we issue the command show client, we should see us as a client. We are connected. That's the ESSID CPPM guest. Yeah. And now this is 5 gigahertz, obviously, 100E. And that's the type of the communication, .11AC. And that's the role that the user has got. Again, this is the one, normally the role is the ESSID role. Again, this is beyond the scope of this. That's what we wanted to say about the ClearPass, either guest authentication or guest based on the cloud-based management or cloud-based splash page or splash page that is hosted on ClearPass as an app solution. You can verify the certificate used in the Aruba Central for the CAFTA portal. And I did issue the command show CAFTA portal domain. show captive portal domains on the access point, it tells you that's a certificate used for captive portal internal. So basically, I have used this HPE.com inside ClearPass. So I showed you this is the same that is used in ClearPass NAS ID.